Here's an easy beef braise for a rainy day that tastes a little of the sun. It's flavored with orange and lime. And you could thicken the sauce with starch, but I thicken this with egg yolk. The result tastes like a beefy hollandaise, which I suppose it literally is. Here's a 3-pound beef chuck roast, 1.36 kilos. It'll feed 4 to 6 people in this meal. And I always look for the ones with lots of intramuscular fat, like those little flecks there. Those taste insanely great in a braised hunk of beef. The intermuscular fat, however, I will trim out the thick bands of fat between the muscle groups. I do not plan to defat this sauce later, so now is my chance to limit the final grease content. I'll cut them into big chunks as I go. They will shrink in half or more by the time we're done cooking them, so if you want big, hearty chunks, you gotta start really big. 16 big pieces, 3 or 4 to each person, should be plenty with all the sides. Chrissy Teigen pan, activate. You'll want something with a lid. A little olive oil just to get this started. Started on pretty high heat, and I'll brown this beef in 2 batches. If you put in too much at once, a ton of water will collect in the pan, and you'll have to boil it out before you can brown anything. If these chunks really stick on you when you do this, it doesn't matter. Just scrape them off. If they get torn up a bit, who cares? They're going to be covered in sauce, and we're really not flavoring the pieces. We're flavoring the whole dish. So if the brown is on the piece or at the bottom of the pan, it really makes no difference. Next batch in, and honestly, one way to keep them from sticking, if you do care, is to keep them moving for the first couple of minutes. When I have a moment of downtime, I will cut an onion in half, peel, and slice into wedges rather than chopping it. I'm going to leave these in the finished sauce, and when I do that, I like to have slightly bigger pieces. They're going to cook down a ton. That beef is plenty brown enough. I have been overzealous about my browning many times in the past. You hit a point of diminishing returns, and then you really risk creating burned flavors that you cannot get out. That much is fine. Before all that, on the bottom burns, get in the onions and move them around a lot. We don't need to cook them all the way, just get some nice brown flavor on them before the liquid goes in. Again, when I have a moment of downtime, I will crush and peel some garlic cloves, and today I think I'm going to throw them in whole. They'll get real soft and mild in the braise. I can see I'm close to burning the fond at the bottom there, so time to squeeze in a little tomato paste, very nice for flavor and color. Stir and brown that for just a sec, and see, I am in imminent danger of burning in that lower left quadrant, so in goes like 2 cups of water, 475 mils. Scrape the bottom a bit, but honestly, everything on the bottom is going to dissolve by itself in time. Beef goes in along with any accumulated juice, and then I'm going to do the zest and juice of an orange. It's much easier to zest before you juice. Way more flavor in that stuff there than in the actual juice, but I want both, and I'm just catching any seeds in my hand there, but it's really no big deal if they go in. I might want a second orange, but I'll be conservative for now. A couple of pinches of salt to start with, and plenty a pepper, and one more flavoring, a New Mexico chili. You could skip this or use 2 or 3. I love whole dried chilies for the musky, almost like raisiny flavor they give stews, and this variety brings hardly any heat at all. Bring this up to a boil and then reduce to a simmer. Cover and cook for like 4 or 5 hours until soft. Not a weeknight meal. For that, I turn to the sponsor of this video, HelloFresh, America's number one meal kit. With fall in the air, it's nice that HelloFresh recipes are seasonal. These will be very great to cozy up to. Fall is also my busiest time of the year work-wise, so it's very helpful that every few nights I just open up a bag, I follow someone else's directions, and in like half an hour I've got dinner. It's less time than a typical trip to the grocery store, and since everything comes pre-portioned, there's no waste, and there's no bits and bobs left over that I have to figure out how to use. And I think these recipes are very clever. This sauce is based on a little packet of jam, which works great. The sweetness is balanced by all the ginger. And this recipe has one other clever trick that I will steal before this video is over. In the meantime, go to HelloFresh.com/AdamRagusia14 and use code AdamRagusia14 for 14 free meals and 3 free gifts. Link and code are in the description. 14 free meals. Thank you, HelloFresh. Here we are after like 2 hours. You'll always want to make sure that you're in no danger of the water all evaporating out, because if that happens, that would be bad. Everything would burn. But this is fine. Tons of water has been coming out of the onion and the beef. I'll taste it, and yeah, I think I'm going to want a second orange in there, zest and juice. You just got to be careful when cooking with fruit juice. Things can get way too sweet really fast, but this is going to be fine with 2 oranges. Cover up and simmer for a couple more hours, and now you can see that I could pull this beef apart if I wanted to, so we're pretty much done. I am I'm going to leave this simmering uncovered for a bit just to reduce down the sauce a little. I still have to prep my sides. I pretty much always want carrots with braised beef. This is a 1 pound bag that I'm peeling. I think you'd want twice that if you were going to eat all of this at once. We're only going to eat half tonight. I'm going to freeze the rest for later, so 454 grams of carrots it is, and I'm cutting them into centimeter thick slices at an attractive angle. You could totally just throw these in with the beef for the last hour of cooking and that'd be fine, but I really liked those roasted carrots I had the other night, so I'm throwing them on a baking sheet with a little oil, pepper, and salt, toss those around, and in they go at like 400 Fahrenheit, 200 C, and they should take 20 minutes max. I'll also get some water boiling for egg noodles, a little salt in there, and Manischewitz makes the best ones, hashtag not an ad. Just half of that one bag, again, because I'm only eating half of my beef tonight. I'll give those carrots a stir, get them recoated in the hot oil, that really helps them to brown better. I've got a lime here that I'm going to zest for the carrots. Beef chunks come out, and I'm already going to have to wash this lid, so I might as well use it for this. Another advantage of braising beef in huge chunks is that they are easy to pick out of the sauce. Why would you want to pick them out of the sauce? Well, if you wanted to be fancy, you could strain this and dump the solids. I am going to fish out the chili and get rid of that, but I actually want to eat everything else that's in there tonight, so no straining. Give that a taste. It needs more salt, and I think it could use a little bit of brightening. You could use vinegar, or I could use this lime that I already have. It goes with the citrus theme, and just half of it should probably do it. Just as I have no moral hesitation about adding acid when something is not acidic enough, I will not hesitate to add sugar when something isn't sweet enough. A little pinch will be real nice. You'd also need to take the beef out to put this in a gravy separator or something to pour off the fat, but because we trimmed the beef, there's really not that much fat floating on top, and I'm going to emulsify it right back in again with an egg yolk. My heat is off, there's no bubbling at all, so I'm safe to put this in and stir briskly. Heat back on. If the beef was still in here, I would be tearing it to shreds right now, by the way. The yolk will come to its full thickening power when you hit a simmer, and then you can assess if you need another one. I think I do. I want this real thick, though I gotta remember it's gonna thicken more as it cools. I'll turn my heat off before I put in the next one. Egg yolk is a terrific thickener, very common in Cajun and Creole cuisine. It has more emulsifying power than butter, and all the protein in there will also serve to thicken the sauce. You gotta be careful to only simmer it, though. Do not boil it. If it gets too hot, it'll go grainy, and the emulsion will break. It'll be real bad. Once it's cooked, I'll cool it down for a sec just to assess the texture at eating temperature. That might even be too thick, but I can always stir in some more water later. Give it a taste. Oh man, that custardy flavor you get from the yolk is outrageous. Beef in very carefully. It's super soft, and unless you want shredded beef, you gotta handle it with kid gloves at this stage. Just get it coated and reheated, and yeah, I think that needs just a little bit more water. I think I'll do some fresh thyme in there. Thyme goes great with citrus, hence lemon thyme. Carrots are done, and yeah, here's the idea that I'm stealing. Toss lime zest through the hot carrots. Phenomenal flavor combination. Drain the egg noodles. You can always toss in a little butter or oil if you're not ready to eat them right away. That'll keep them from sticking together, but I'm ready to eat right now. One thing you're going to notice is that this is not the most attractive sauce you've ever seen. It would be prettier if we had strained the braising liquid, but still, the egg yolks give it a kind of gloopy look. Who cares? I'll give myself a little bunch of cilantro, and for your thumbnail, you're going to want to put a wedge of orange on top. I'm sure that's something you worry about as much as I do. If you have leftovers, just be sure to reheat them real gently so you don't overcook the egg. With the citrus, that really tastes like a meaty hollandaise sauce on this buttery soft beef. Like I said, a rainy day meal that tastes of the sun really hit the spot.